Hello, everybody. So we have another kind of a review. I have to turn on my lights quickly.
I feel like I just play awful under the glare of my TV. But we do have another review. In a way,
we are reviewing Tolisso here. Kind of in a way, just another secret player review. Upamecano. Now we had a video before, but it got cut in between. Really just one thing that. Well, one major thing that happened in that game was Tolisso had a very good interception, and he legit passed it on a through ball right when he got that interception, and it was a goal. So that was very nice to see from Tolisso. Now, I don't know if it was me moving him into that position or himself. I think it was a mix of both. But nevertheless, it is still good to see that sometimes in this game you can challenge right in front of the ball and you don't get it. And it's good to see that Tolisso got the ball. When it was challenged right in front of him, or when it was rather passed right in front of him. So we will be playing him this formation. He might be on stay back. I do think he is on stay back. But I don't think. I feel like a lot of people might be thinking CDM. Probably more midfield. I don't know. But I do have him on stay back, I think. So just have that in mind, but here we go into a game. Again, it's a very fun squad. I really like playing with squad just because it is so fun to play with. I have so much fun playing with squad, with the squad. So that is what we will do. This guy spent like 0 coins on his defense, but quite a bit on his offense, and it looks like he missed out on Fakir. But I did Fakir. I thought he was great value. And how good, I had 700 against Fakir, I don't have him anymore. Or I do have him, but I don't use him. I feel like he's incredibly funky now. But, I haven't played a Fakir in a while as well. I don't even remember the last time I played Fakir. Anyways, let's get into the game.
Well, thanks, Derek. The best coach I played under would always tell us before kickoff, earn the right to play.
Ooh, if you can win your individual that's battle, just a skill move, outrun I think. Your opponent,
eventually you'll get the space to show your ability. I'm sure that would be an echo.
Okay. So that was really bad defending, it's just he had a fucking shot there. I feel like outside the box shots are so RNG half of the time. That's a good goal. Rangers restarting the game. It's up to them to wipe out that last goal. He's in here. Why does he have to? Don't know why he doesn't shoot it. Dude, do not know why he doesn't shoot it. Took years to get that ball off. Years. Just ruined it. Like, it was great, and then he just didn't want to fucking shoot it. There's only so much I can do. Nice hoopa. An inability to keep hold of the ball there. This could square the game. Damn it.
Well, that was a big chance, and really, he should have taken that. But let's give credit to the goalkeeper.
Oh, it might be. Let's go, Yetter. Let's go, Yetter. Wait, it's police involved. This is a police review. I guess it is harder to review midfielders, though. Good interception. Good pass. Leads to a goal. Nice, man. Nice. I should have probably pinged that pass, the R1 pass. I think it's called a direct pass. I probably should have done that, but hey, good ball. Get him off. Good agility there, and he got him off the ball there, which is nice.
Neymar.
Oh no, game. Game. Yes, Upa. Come on, man. Oh man, I had him.
Now with Tolisso.
Oof, I mistimed that. I had him as well. I had that one-on-one. I just didn't commit, and I've never been in that situation, actually. So I was like, oh, I'm in a good situation, but I've never been in that situation, actually. So I was like, oh, what do I do here?
Might be able to get in behind the defense.
Yeah, does he only shoot outside the fucking box shots? The fuck? Why do you think I'd go backwards there as well?
He's got space.
Goal Tolisso! Nice! Nice! Goal Tolisso. Nice. Good finish as well. Usually, my two midfielders are Paqueta and Guendouzi. I really expect them to score things kind of like in the penalty inside, from where you shoot a penalty, and inside that is where I expect a goal, and it's nice that he gets that goal from the outside of that range. The thing about it is he should only get better. Ooh, shit, Upa. What the fuck is Chernobyl doing? I'm glad I told you not to do Chernobyl. Where is he running to? Did he have short term memory? What the fuck happened there? He's so sus sometimes. He's so good with his strength. Now, other times they do shit like that. They're sitting there like, what the fuck are you doing? You know? That's fucking ridiculous. Like, that is fucking ridiculous right there. I think a child could defend better than that, because he'd be focused on the ball. I generally have no idea what Trevor's focused on there. Wow, I got so lucky that I'm challenging with Trevor, and it does it for Paqueta for some reason. Four. Oh, I missed that. I went far, but maybe that's composure and him pushing me. I don't know. Mike Conte's on his ass. Well, those stats back up what they've been watching. Really one-sided game, and it's far too easy for them to open up this defense. This could turn into a rout. Oh, Stuart, they could be in here. Nice, Upa, with that strength. Element of risk there, but he's won the ball. It's been a three-back as well. Ben Yedder. Oh, damn, I thought I had time to get that pass off. It's my fault. Ooh, and I don't steal that ball. I feel like I'm right in front of that one. McConnell, very close for interception, but not close enough. And that's not a good shot. It's not a bad shot. He just didn't have a lot of power on it. I feel like that was his problem. If he had more power, maybe that's a goal. But it's annoying how, you know, you can score that. Don't feel like that's right. He's off. Who's not? Bam. The rat. The rat. I'm surprised that wasn't off, and he's out of here. I'm surprised that wasn't off. I thought if you're behind the halfway line, everything's fair play. That must have been, I don't know. Nice though, nice. So we're gonna play three games, or at least three games that are worthy of review. What happened that game is I think he had an interception and a pass for a goal, I think, or he got an interception that led to a goal, which is nice. Again, like Chernobyl, I want to like him so much, but just when he forgets where he is in the middle of the fucking game, there's only so much I can do, you know. Anyways, let's get back into it. Upa didn't play bad, though. Didn't play bad at all. And I'm a little surprised because his pace works in such a weird way, but he played really good there, and I'm picking up on that more and more. As I said, I had to re-record this in a way because my other game got cut short because of dinner. And Upamecano, as I said, this is just a fun team. I got Upamecano out of my Future Stars player pick, reunion player pick. Hey! He's been well. He's been doing pretty well. I don't know how he'll perform at a two center back, but he's been doing really well. I have that to say about him. We'll talk about that. Actually, we'll talk about the viability, where I think he's going to go. And this is coming from somebody who does watch football. I'm not like a... I don't know. I don't want to sound like Ashley Cole at left wing back. Oh my God. It's creative. You could say this team's creative, I guess. I don't know what I'm looking at. Like, does he play? God. He must have him at midfield. Yeah, that's a weird team. Like, does he play a five? I don't know. Good interception. Well, Derek, when looking forward to this game, you can't help but notice there are some great matchups all over the pitch, particularly in those. Oh, two stories. If the challenge went off, I feel like he got that. If not, then no.
Benzema.
You're just doing fucking... I haven't played something like this in a while. I just pass it to fucking pass it. Fortunately or unfortunately. What is this?
And here's the starting 11 for Rangers.
Ooh, oh my god, Piquetti is actually dribbling? Without stuttering every like other step he takes? I think it is like a 5-back or something. That ball isn't the best, whoever gave that. Probably should have had more pace on it, or maybe I should have through-balled it. I don't think I through-balled it. Which was the problem there.
He's driven in the corner.
Okay, let's get this goalkeeper out, and that should go for a... Nope.
Guile from that corner, keeper's ball. And here's the starting 11 for Rangers. Aaron Ramsdale is the goalkeeper. Cristiano Ronaldo starts alongside Corentin Tolisso.
Got it, Oompa, you've got to get back. I'm fucked right now.
Provided today by Karim Benzema.
All right, at least I think that was Oompa. There he is, Oompa made that run back and saved me. Maybe he's lucky I dragged him so out of position because he was right there. He got back right in the time.
Well, Derek, over the years he scored so many goals.
Wasn't a bad play, it's not a good one.
Spinning behind defenders at such pace, when the ball's played in behind, nobody catches him, and he often gets 1v1 against the goalkeeper, and we know what the result is.
Where are you going?
And delivered by Neymar here. Not quite the clearance they were hoping for.
God damn, man. Dombich is so good at dribbling, he can't do that. That's kind of disappointing. He's wide open on that through ball. Just would not let me switch to Maldini there.
Running with the ball confidently.
This is all this fucking guy does. Just fucking cross my mind. I mean, I guess that's what you do when you play a through back. All he's going to do is cross it. Okay, keep that in mind. All he's fucking going to do is cross it.
No damage done. Look as though they want to make this move count.
Good pass.
Good play.
I'm going to cross it.
That's an effective cross.
To be fair, Plisic is never winning that. Well, I don't know if I'm crossing it there as well. If Plisic is never winning that. Maybe because I can't really do anything. Damn it, I gave him that. Go back up. Go out. Yeah, all he's going to fucking do is cross it. He'll get one of them. Crossing is all RNG. If every time he fucking gets a ball, he's just gonna fucking cross, he'll get one of them.
Magnificent defending.
Good pass, Conte. Good pass.
Paqueta. Neymar. Lucas Paqueta. Oh, surely.
Good finish. That was nice. Yeah, fuck you, Mbabu. Or no, I take that back, Mbabu. You're a FIFA 20 legend with your UCL Live card. Never mind. I did not mean that, Kevin. The Kevster, I did not mean that, Kevster. Old Kev. Kevin is a FIFA. I used his UEL Live card. Oh my god, that card was so nasty. I legit used it to the end of the year. Great, great by Upa Meccano. That auto challenge was amazing.
Zule acquitted himself superbly to win it back.
Oof. Right back to him. I don't like to see that Tolisso, but I think that's the game, not you. Give him a false sense of that he has room. Thanks, Upa, for the strength.
Well, the stats show us that the hosts haven't had that much of the ball.
Like, fucking Paqueta's dribbling.
In deep areas, they've got forward with
pace. And he switches play like that? Like, who am I playing with?
Oh, he's really up on the mark here.
And Paqueta scores that Paqueta! Oh my god, who am I playing with right now? That's a great goal right there. Great. Great goal right there. Great goal right there. Great fucking goal right there. I mean, he switched it. He switched the play as well. Sometimes I think Paqueta's a fraud. That is really, really, really nice. Very nice. So now we have one more game. We have one more game, but then now we have to, unfortunately. I want to stay D5. I feel like if I go up a division, the gameplay isn't fun. It's a sweat fest. So We have to play with this bad team and lose. But usually when you play with bad players, the good players stand out. So Tolisso should stand out this game. Now on the viability of Tolisso getting the upgrade. They can lose against Salzburg. They can. I watched about half on and off. I had like a little like speaker. Oh, he has Kamara. I wonder how he plays. I had a speaker talk and I couldn't watch it while he was talking, so I couldn't watch the game. Although what I took from the game and the time that I watched it is Salzburg had that cutting edge. Their knife was sharp at times. If Pavard doesn't make that goal line clearance, if their goalkeeper doesn't have an amazing save, he made this one amazing save, Salzburg wins that game. Now, Bayern did have the possession. They did have the more shots. But at the same time, Lewandowski played bad. They've played some really entertaining football in recent weeks. Ooh, Phil Jones is slow there. But at the same time, Lewandowski played really bad. And hey, Lewandowski is the shit. So maybe that's just an off game. Who fucking knows? They definitely can lose to Salzburg. Realistically, will they lose to them? No. It's a home game. What the fuck happened there? It's a home game for Bayern. You know, at the end of the day, they're fucking Bayern Munich. As much as I wouldn't want Davies to win a UCL, I'd like to see this card get upgraded one or two times. Preferably to the semifinal. Preferably to the semifinal. Who's this? Oh, that's Tolisso! I was like, who's this? He's feeling bad on the ball. Like, am I using Jury? Ooh! Tolisso, oh my god, buddy, jeez. Like, come on, use it, like, he doesn't feel bad. Do not take that, he just fucking spamming skill moves with big header. What a fucking rodent. He didn't feel amazing on the ball, but personally with me, I am a body type kind of guy. Shit, I can score this. Damn it. I'm a body type kind of guy, and better make it nice. Let's go, Phil! Come on, Phil! Can't believe he was supposed to be like the oh my god, he's on his ass. Nice, Schlotterbeck. I hope you get that upgrade during team of the week, which you probably won't, but still, that'd be cool if you did. Whoa! Where are you going? Where are you? Oh shit! You just need to get the pass off. But what was it? Yes. So the feasibility of them getting upgraded, I feel like the next upgrade, he will get upgraded, and then the next upgrade is dependent on, come on, Tolisso, show his pace. Great cross as well, Tolisso, come on! It was a great idea playing, No, I reached the checkpoint. Okay, I have to end the review here. What a rodent, though. He spans skill moves on the freaking kickoff as well. And yeah, what a rodent with Ben Yedder as well. What a rodent. And he gave me a checkpoint. No, I'm on a plus two as well. I feel like I'm fine, though. Yeah, what a rodent. What an absolute rodent. But Tolisso with that goal and that cross was very nice, very nice. Very, very nice. So I played Tolisso at a balanced CDM, and I played him at a, that's a good goal. That is a good goal. I don't know why he quit, though. God damn it, I'm almost D4. Ugh, damn it. Tolisso, now we're at the end of the review, because I don't want to win a game. I don't want to win a game with Tolisso. Realistically, as I said, as I was saying, I do think that Tolisso does win against Salzburg, although it is definitely not guaranteed. Although I do think, like, they beat Salzburg. And then that next round is just decided on who they play. I feel like right now, Bayern has a lot of injuries, namely Goretzka, I don't know how much, how, like, I feel like a lot of goalkeeping is situational. So if, God, I gotta sell this Romero. So like, it doesn't matter as much. Cause I feel like if the striker's in a good position, there's only so much a goalkeeper can do. I'm gonna list him for, bought him for 28 and he's 27. So for 31. I want to get this, or do I want to get, I like Tolisso. I'll listen for 33. But 2, 3, 1, 2, let me check the market history. Sorry guys, I just want to make sure that I'm not, I want to make sure that I get the most out of Romero. I did like Romero, by the way, as well. I put him in the 3-back, so where Upamecano was, and I did like Romero. And I feel like, hey, 30k for something like that, honestly, for me, is a steal. I feel very confident with Romero, and I got another best one. What the fuck did I do? Transfer market? Yeah. Already in the season. I do like this kid, by the way. I feel like this alien kid's really cool. Sucks that I probably took the place in the pack, but hey, it's cool. It's cool. Back to the player. As I said, they probably get through the first round. The second round, it depends. I feel like the only, let's check, actually, the UCL. UCL. Champions League. Alright, so, they will beat Benfica Ajax. They'll beat Sporting. Oh, no. So, it'll be probably City, PSG, and Liverpool. City, PSG, or Liverpool. Could Bayern beat City? No. Could Bayern beat PSG? No. Could Bayern beat Liverpool? No. Chelsea, Lille. Chelsea wins. Villarreal, Juventus. I think Juventus wins. Bayern Ajax, I think Ajax wins. Atletico Manchester, that's a toss-up. I honestly think that Manchester scrapes away with this one. So I feel like the only way that he can get another upgrade after the initial two, I think he goes to an 88 if they win, but he might get another one for qualifying. Anyways, so he will get an upgrade for playing for win and if they beat Salzburg. And I feel like the only way he will get another upgrade is if they get whoever wins the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So they have like a 45% chance of getting a favorable draw. So Tolisso has a 45% chance, which is more like a 50, honestly. I would say it's 50-50. I'm saying 45 because there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 other groups in the knockouts right now. And I feel like they have a chance at winning 3 of them. But then I'm going to add another 5% in there, because at the end of the day, they're Bayern Munich. Who knows? You know, they have Lewandowski. I feel like Kimmich is a good CDM, but I feel like the only game changer they have is really Lewandowski. Maybe a Sané, although Sané didn't really play well against Salzburg. And I'm going to stick with that. I feel like maybe it depends on Lewandowski because all the players hurt right now. So I'm just going to say it's a toss-up. I say it's a 50-50. I think he goes to a, if my upgrades are correct, he goes to a either a 90 or a 91. I think it will be a 90. I'm going to keep the guess conservative because it's better to keep it conservative than overzealous. It could be plus 3. Can we look it up? I think it's on the title screen, actually. On the title screen, but does it have it? So win first, quarter, semis, final. So win first game, and they have to qualify for the quarterfinals. So the quarterfinals are after. So semifinals means that there's four teams.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so he gets a 2 then. Yes, okay. So if he wins the first game, he gets a plus 2 then? Because quarterfinals are 4? And there's 4 teams in the quarterfinals? Four groups in quarterfinals? So yes. If he wins, it's a plus 2. If Byron wins, it's a plus 2. So, I feel like he will be... yes, okay. So he'll probably get a... He has a 80% chance of getting a plus 2. And I think he has a 50% chance of getting a plus... and then after that plus 2, I feel like he has a 50% chance of getting another plus 1. And then honestly, after that plus 1, honestly, I feel like that's it. I only feel like you're looking at a plus 3 to all of his stats. As I said, Bayern isn't at 100%. And I feel like City is stronger than Bayern. I feel like PSG is stronger than Bayern. I don't know if Liverpool is stronger than Bayern right now. But I feel like PSG... is Chelsea stronger than Bayern? I don't know. But Bayern definitely isn't up there. If it was a PSG card, then I'd be... If it was a PSG City card, I'd be like, okay. But it's a Bayern card. A lot of the players are injured. And they haven't been in the best of form as well. But this is as of, like, February 20th. So that is subject to change. But they haven't been in the best of form. So we will see with this card. In my opinion, I feel like he'll get a plus 3. I feel like they're Bayern. I feel like they'll beat Salzburg and they'll beat their next opponent. But other than that, it's a toss-up. I don't mind it. I feel like he is a good card at 88. What could be better? I mean, I'm not looking at his stats, but like, what could have been better on him? His strength could have been better. His strength and stamina, namely his stamina. My main problem with him is his stamina. When I played in the 3 back, when I was playing, I played like 1.5 games. His stamina was like 55. Or no, it was 79 going into the second half, to where Conte's was at 89. I want to be subbing off. Probably I wouldn't be wanting to be subbed or wanting to take anybody off. But if I look at my team, I'm probably subbing Maldini, Zola, and that's probably maybe an attacker if I'm losing, a midfielder if I need to hold the lead, which is probably a midfielder, and then a defender if I'm trying to scrape the barrel for the result. But honestly, just the stamina was the main problem, in my opinion, with this card. The stamina and then the strength. But now this is... The stats might not reflect it. You know, his finishing isn't the best. His crossing isn't the best. His grip isn't the best. Agility balance isn't the best. Although that goal that I scored with him, he didn't feel awful. He didn't feel awful. He felt adequate. He felt... fine. He didn't feel amazing, but didn't feel bad. I made it like, oh my god, he feels amazing. I said that out of surprise, like, oh my god, I thought Tolisso felt so bad, and here I am with a situation where he's cutting in and out fine. Like, his dribbling is fine. His passing is good. His pace is good. His shooting is bang average for a CM, I'd say. Not bang average, because he scored that good goal for me. But why am I switching on my team? It's fine. His defense, I didn't, like, I don't know. Maybe you run a Hunter, maybe you, I don't know where you're playing. For me, he's a CM. I would rate this card, why am I switching so much? I would rate this card a 7. I would rate this card a 7. Or a 6.5 to 7, 6.75 is what I'd say. 6. I'm gonna stick with 6. Reason why,
is because he has one, or no, no, 6.75. I'm going to stick with that. I feel like he's relatively cheap for a good link midfielder that will get upgraded. I feel like that is fine. As long as you get him under 200K, I feel like that is fine. He was 160 on PS4, I think, or low 170. I would, if you're needing a CM, I would pay for that. The work rate, I am the kind of superstitious. I want somebody with, for me on my team, my Guendouzi and my Paquette are high. They're doing everything. They are defending and they're attacking. His work rate, I'm not playing with him all the time, and I didn't play him in my main formation. I can tell him my main formation, I didn't play with him in it. I played with him in a fun formation. And he was fine in that formation. And I feel like he'll be fine in whatever you play him. I don't think the work rates mean a lot, but for me, I'm superstitious. But for him, I feel like he's fine at the end of the day. Anything really else to say? Just to wrap it up, I feel like he's a 6.75. If you can get him under 200K, because he has good links and he's in a good league and he'll basically get a plus 3, I think he'll get a plus 3. He might be guaranteed a plus 2. I feel like that's fine. Just get him under 200K. He had some really good passes. Only negatives are his stamina and maybe his strength. Anyways, that was it for this review. What I really hope is I helped out maybe one or two people in deciding, hey, whether they want to buy Tolisso or not. I doubt we'll do a Martinez review just because they might lose the Sporting. I feel like the potential of somebody upgrading is so, like, cool, and that makes me engaged and want to do it. I don't know if... Oh, no! They played Sporting in their group already. Did they? No, they played somebody else Sporting. No, they did. Ajax did play Sporting in their group. So Ajax should beat Sporting then. Although that Sporting game was close. It was like 3-2, I think. It was a close game.
Can I look at that? Ajax. Oh, no, they're playing Benfica. Never mind, they're playing Benfica. And I need to go to Benfica just to see how they do. So they lost to Sporting. And they lost Sporting. So Sporting is a better team than Benfica. And Sporting lost to Ajax in a close game. And Sporting lost to Benfica twice. So I would say that's consistent. So, I feel like Ajax should win it if you're going for an Ajax thing. But hey, this is a stage review. That one person that maybe made it to the end of this or maybe is listening to this, I don't know why they're doing whatever. I hope I helped you out. I hope this video was of service. Upamecano isn't bad. When I played him in my feedback formation, now his sprint speed or his acceleration, I didn't notice. Honestly, I didn't notice. I wasn't looking for it. You might be looking for it. I wasn't. He worked. It is weird, though, the sprint speed acceleration. Very weird, very weird. But he was fine. I wasn't like, oh my god, he's freezing, he's turning into a snowman. He's losing his legs. I didn't notice that. That is that. Thank you for watching, and that is the Tolisso review.